Today on Traveling Young,
the world's largest virtual beer tasting
here from Tivoli Gardens in Copenhagen.
We're the Youngs.
We've spent our lives traveling the world.
And in 2018, we moved from
Chicago, Illinois to
Copenhagen, Denmark.
Now we want to share with you
how our new lives abroad
is keeping us young.
Keeping us young.
Are helping to keep us young. Welcome back to Traveling Young. All right, so I'm a little bit red, as you can see. We got some fantastic amounts of sun over this weekend.
Worth it, though.
It's a rarity in Denmark. It's like,
I don't know what's... going into summer. The sun is out.
Yeah, it was a lot of sun, though. It was fantastic. But I also don't like... I think it, like, emphasizes the gray more. I feel like it pops more as my skin tone.
You've got the silver fox thing going on.
I don't know. Maybe. Yeah. It's like more like sporadic. But we had such an amazing time, and we felt like it was, we're in the moment. It was hard to kind of connect everything that was happening.
Yeah.
So
it was a fun time. So
there was a lot going on.
Yeah.
So we want to quickly give you an intro of what the day is about, where we get to go to the beer tasting, but it actually all starts with an amazing interview that we were lucky enough to have.
Yeah, and we were so excited to be joined by Mikaela Svane, who is the Chief Marketing Officer from Tivoli, and she had lots to tell us, so let's go to that interview and find out what she has to say.
We are here at Tivoli Gardens today, one of my favorite places to go, and I'm so excited because we're at the world's largest virtual beer tasting. And I'm here with Mikaela Svane, who works here at Tivoli, the Chief Marketing Officer. So tell me all about this event, because we're so excited about it.
Well, during the pandemic, some of all the small microbreweries here in Denmark really struggled. So we decided to create this event, where people can buy a case with 12 beers and some cocktails and taste from the safety of their homes. And we have around about 250 people tasting right here from Tivoli with the stage, and it's transmitted through Facebook and the national TV2 television.
So cool.
So we're going to taste a lot of beer today.
Yeah. Now, we moved here in 2018. We've been members ever since we came here. But we did come in 2012, and this was one of the places we absolutely had to come to. What do you think it is about Tivoli that makes it a go-to place for people outside of Denmark? You know, when tourists come, they're like, we have to go to Tivoli. What is it about it?
Well, Tivoli is the second oldest amusement park in the world, and Walt Disney was here in 1951 and was said to be inspired to open Disneyland after he was here. And the famous Danish author Hans Christian Andersen was inspired to write the fairy tale The Nightingale.
Yeah.
So Tivoli somehow managed to incorporate all the fun of an amusement park with a sense of serenity and beauty of the garden.
Yeah, it's beautiful. So you can go ride a ride and then you can go right around to the lake, and it's so gorgeous.
Yeah.
Now, you guys have events all year long and they're so much fun. We come here all the time, and you guys have a special slogan. So what is the slogan about Tivoli?
Well, our slogan is always like never before, and it was inspired by our founder, Georg Carstensen, who back in 1843 said, Tivoli will never be finished. So it's in our DNA to create new events and always do new magical stuff that hopefully get the guests to come back for more.
Yeah. And how many of these special events do you have throughout the year?
Usually we have more than 2,000 events each year.
Wow.
So
there's
a lot going on, as you can hear.
Tivoli's obviously been here for quite a long time. How far back do these special events go? Like, do you know when they had the first one and what that was? And
The cultural events like theater and music has been part of Tivoli ever since the opening in 1843. The first musical director in Tivoli was the composer Lumpy. So the first music here was classical concert. And of course, we have the pantomime theater right behind us here.
Yeah.
That's the oldest building in Tivoli. It dates back to 1874.
Yeah.
So it's always been part of Tivoli.
Yeah. And what's been your favorite? You've been here with Tivoli for a while. So what's been your favorite event?
Oh, that's a tough question. I love the Christmas season. It's absolutely magical to have a Christmas fairy tale wonderland right here in the center of Copenhagen.
Yeah.
I love Halloween.
Yeah. Halloween is my favorite. We always come for Halloween.
Yeah.
And we often come in costume too, which I think is probably over the top for most people, but it's so much fun.
Yeah, But yeah, but I also love the open air Friday night rock concert during the summer. So there's so many much to choose from. I can't pick one.
What's new this year? Tell us about some of the exciting things that are happening this year.
We have a lot of exciting news this year. In the end of May, we're going to open a new scary house called Villa Vendetta in the old Tivoli Castle.
I don't think I can do that one.
Right over here. And we're going to have two new Michelin restaurants opening this summer. So, and as a new thing, we're going to celebrate the 4th of July weekend.
That is amazing! Yeah.
So we're going to have a Cadillacs right here.
That's so cool.
Exciting guests from the US.
And probably
hot dogs.
We'll definitely have to come and check. But they're American hot dogs, so we'll have to make sure they meet the American standards and not the Danish.
You'll have to come and test.
Yes. How has the pandemic changed your planning for all of these events?
Well, usually we have around 20 to 30,000 people to our concerts here on Friday nights, but we try to develop new concept that will that we can have for smaller scales, fewer people.
So that's such a great idea.
Later this month, we're going to introduce a new Friday festival with small lounges and cocktails and beers and DJs and live music, but at smaller scales so that we can have the event during the restrictions that we work under.
Well, this has been so great, Mikola. Thank you so much for telling us about Tivoli and all these special events that you have. Be sure, if you ever stop in Tivoli, look at their calendar because there's always something going on. But for today, I think it's time we go around the park and maybe try some beers.
I agree.
All right.
Right, so we were so fortunate that she spent that time with us. Basically, it was minutes before this massive event was supposed to start.
We're so grateful, though, and it's always so special when we get to do those things and learn more about Tivoli and all the events that they have. And I was amazed that they have 2,000 events every year. It's crazy.
They pull off so much, and it's such an amazing place. Yeah. We've been members since we've been here, so it was so neat to talk to her and learn a little bit more about one of our place's favorite. I can't even talk.
Oh, no.
I have not been drinking now. This is days later. One of my favorite places in Copenhagen. But after that interview, we basically immediately went to our seats and started with what was chaos. It was organized. I just think we weren't organized.
No, we were not organized, but we had so much fun. So much fun.
So, just be prepared for what feels like a bit of randomness as we go from beer to beer.
It wasn't well planned.
But I tried to capture some interesting moments as we went through the day. And check it out. It was the world's largest virtual beer tasting. And we were there.
We were.
What's this all about?
Beer!
We have the always present for beer, Peter, at the end there.
Peter.
LP, who mixes between candy, Thanksgiving meals, and beer.
And now beer.
And future concerts, when we can actually go to concerts again.
And I just always am drinking liquor, I feel like, on camera.
And it's not even Tuesday.
It's not Tuesday. So, you know.
This will air on Tuesday. You just messed up the magic.
Oh my God.
You gave away the magic.
I cannot wait.
This is Tuesday. We're Tuesday.
We have all these beers we're going to try. I'm very excited to see who's going to win.
I think we're going to win. Yeah. What do you guys think?
We're all winners.
I don't think we'll remember. Well, that's the beauty of TV magic. We can watch it again.
Yeah, that's true. We can see us all getting smashed again.
All right. Well, as you can tell, it hasn't started yet.
Yeah.
We're all still quite aware of our surroundings. Here, there's the stage. All right. Let's do this.
We're ready.
Right, this is the second beer. I'm gonna have the second beer now. Oh, that's good. This second one's good.
So we're like almost, but not quite halfway through. How you feeling?
Yeah, good.
Good. Yes.
Warming up.
Yeah. Outside.
It's been tasty.
It's a good event so far, yeah.
Yeah. I enjoy it.
All right, we're like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 beers in.
How are you feeling?
I need some water because I poured it in my glass a minute ago and I could barely.
He poured it all over the table, you guys. He's doing good.
It's good.
You can do it, Rock.
I can do it. Explain to me what we call the people that take our bottles away.
So we got a problem because we need to keep track of what we're drinking. And the only way to do that is to place the bottles in front of us so we can see what we're having, like these two ones. But we have someone called Bottle Vultures. They're coming. They're stealing our bottles and putting new bottles in front of us. It's impossible to keep track.
So because we were at Tivoli for the drinking festival, we thought that Tried on Tuesday should also be at Tivoli. And I'm going to try some Goof, which for those non-Goof connoisseurs in the world, it's a candy, marshmallowy, liquidy type thing that goes on top of ice cream here in Denmark. And this place right here is the first place we ever had it when we came on vacation in 2012. And it's basically the only place I've ever gotten it, although I know it's available in other parts of Denmark, but we felt like it'd be a Tivoli-inspired edition today of Tried on Tuesday, and goof, here we go. Of course, I already know what it tastes like. And sometimes they give you so much, there's more goof than ice cream. I told she was like, do you want more? And I'm like, I don't even see the ice cream anymore. No, no. It is special. And if you need an extra burst of sugar high, Goof is the way to go. For this week's Tried on Tuesday, Goof.
I mean, one of the most Danish things ever. What did you say?
It's going to start raining. It's going to start raining.
Why are you so negative? Because you grew up in Denmark?
It's not a negative thing. It's just...
It's reality?
It's reality. It's a realism thing, yeah. This is what I live for. It's really good.
So you're easy to please, is that what you're telling me?
I am definitely easy to please. Anything sour and anything Belgian, I'm there. Yeah.
This is tasty. Yeah. I like it.
Peter?
I like this. This is like...
Pull out the bottle.
Here it is.
That's one.
Look at that.
Is it great?
It's I think beyond great. This is really, really craftsmanship.
Yeah.
Which is a very difficult word to say after 10 beers.
So this is like a woodworker's...
A woodworker's
beer? I don't know.
I don't know where you were going with
that. I'm like a craftsman.
It's a craftsman's craft beer.
It's a woodworker's plank.
Yeah.
That's all of it.
Beers.
That's the end.
Look, Peter isn't, he can't even.
Beer goggles.
Beer goggles. This has been super cool.
It's been a good experience.
Thank you, Peter, for coming up with this idea, by the way. Well, you didn't come up with the idea of the event, but you came up with the idea of us attending the event.
Yeah.
So thank you.
Thanks. And I really enjoyed the company. Four.
Three. I'm not three.
How was it? This was more than all right, I would say.
Yeah?
Yeah. This is above an average Saturday in my book, that's all right.
Yeah. LB?
He's logging beers.
What?
He's
no.
Logging beers.
I'm logging beers.
Logging beers. Very important.
Very important.
Pick up the last one.
This is supposed to be for tomorrow, but he already drank it.
Yeah.
That's good. Okay.
It's a bit unfair because it's after a stout,
it is,
so it's very
it's
chill.
Good.
Welcome back. That was
so much fun.
A ton of fun. I mean, it's now Monday night for us.
And we're still
and
excited
we're still,
about it.
You know, I slept well Sunday after I got all this sun.
Yeah.
It was just a lot of fun. I was really impressed at how well it was organized.
Yeah, I mean, they had all the tables laid out. We all had these little scorecards to score the beers. And the whole production was just like, it was like a TV show, even though it was online. And they were cutting away to people in Ghana and all over Denmark. And it was just so much fun from beginning to end.
And the first time I heard live music in a long time.
I know. I realized that when I was out crazy dancing, because I know some of you saw that online. But I realized that was the first time I had heard live music in, what, a year?
It's been quite a while. I mean, we went to that like drive-in thing, which is probably in May-ish or June-ish.
Yeah.
It was quite a while ago.
Yeah, it was a long time.
That was a lot of fun. And just to see a band and a drum kit.
No, get up and dance and have fun. Yeah.
It was a great event. So Tivoli did a fantastic job. And we set the world record.
We did.
We were part of it. I hope some of you guys were part of it too. It was funny at work today. I saw somebody had posted in Slack a picture that they were there, which I didn't realize. One of my work colleagues was there, and he had a picture of the scorecard. And
oh, wow.
I was like, hey, I was there too. It was a ton of fun. I mean, it was just, it was
so
cool.
And
it seems like quite a few people participated in some way.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad that we got to do it. It was a lot of fun.
It was I think it's one of those things you'll always remember doing. So.
Yeah. And it was great to have LP there.
Yeah.
And Peter, of course, my beer drinking buddy. I mean, it was just a great time. So I hope we captured a little bit of the excitement in the loosely knit story of what we were going through.
Chaotic.
I was drinking the whole time. So my operating skills of camera, just were slowly deteriorating.
Well, yeah, and I'm a lightweight, so towards the end, it was just...
But thank you for joining us, and next year, hopefully they do it again, and if they do, I'm pretty sure we'll be there.
Yeah, I think we will.
And hopefully you guys can join as well.
Yes.
But thank you for watching this today. We appreciate it, and stay tuned on Friday. We have part two of our trip to...
Moon.
Such a great time to Moon's Clint. We can't wait for you to see it. I can't wait to finish putting it together. It was... Watch all the footage again, because it was a lot of fun.
Such a great day. Yeah. I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. Another day full of sun.
Yeah, we've gotten a lot of sun lately. Yeah. But anyway, lots of cool things planned. Next one for you, Mons Clint.
Yeah.
And that's it. I think we're going to go and maybe, I don't know.
Maybe get some rest.
Get some rest. It's been a long couple days. But we got a long weekend coming up.
Yes.
So we're excited about that.
So much planned.
Yeah. All right. Yep. Anyway, thank you so much. Brisket here. He says goodbye.
He's the void. He's there. You can't see him, but he's there.
We say goodbye. We'll see you later.
Bye.